Welcome back to MinuteMed. We will be discussing the pathology of acute tubular necrosis in this video. What is acute tubular necrosis? Acute means it happens suddenly. Tubular means it involves the renal tubular cells. And necrosis means cell death and cell injury. So the death and necrosis of renal tubular cells on sudden onset is called acute tubular necrosis. Acute tubular necrosis is the most common cause of acute renal injury. If you are not familiar with acute renal injury, the link to our video will be down below in the description, so you can go and check it out. Statistically speaking, 45% of all cases of acute kidney injury is caused by acute tubular necrosis. Right, so the causes of acute tubular necrosis can either be ischemic or nephrotoxic. Speaking of ischemia, this happens when there's low renal blood flow to the kidney and there's less renal perfusion, which means there's not enough oxygen for the renal tubular cells to survive. Meanwhile, nephrotoxins are toxic substances like aminoglycosides, radiocontrast agents, and lead, which can cause injury to the renal tubular cells. Both these mechanisms can cause cellular injury, which lead to tubular necrosis and ultimately leading to the death of renal parenchyma cells. So a person with acute tubular necrosis will present himself with extreme hypoperfusion due to blood loss and prolonged hypotension. For example, any kind of trauma or accident and any major surgery with severe blood loss and prolonged hypotension. And especially in the cases of myocardial infarction or heart attack, when the cardiac output of the heart decreases, leading to ischemic damage to the kidney. So one thing that's common in all these instances is that if the renal tubular cells are damaged, it means there is no proper filtration happening in the kidney. And therefore, these patients will present themselves with oliguria or decreased passing of urine. Since they are not passing out enough urine, they will have a high serum creatinine level. So acute tubular necrosis happens in three stages: initiation phase, maintenance phase, and recovery phase. Let's go into detail into each of these phases. Number one, initiation phase. When ischemia hits the nephron, eventually renal tubules will undergo apoptosis and break off the cells into the lumens of tubules. So these cells, which are shedded off from the wall of the tubules, will pass along with our urine and leave the characteristic muddy brown casts in the urine sediment. Also, these cells will accumulate in the lumen of the tubules, causing obstruction. So urine cannot pass through freely. And when the tubules are obstructed this way, some kind of a pressure is sent back into the glomerulus and the GFR will decrease even further. Another important thing to note is that the proximal convoluted tubule and the thick ascending loop of Henle is more susceptible to ATN damage. So the reason for this is that these parts of the nephron are involved more in active transport of ions because they create ATP. So if they don't have enough oxygen, they can't make enough ATP. So they are more susceptible for this damage. So not just renal tubular cells, even vascular cells are affected from this ischemia as well. The endothelial cells lining the afferent arterioles are also damaged in this case. In our cardiac pathology videos, we learned that nitric oxide, which is produced from these endothelial cells, is a potent vasodilator. It dilates the blood vessels so we can increase the blood flow and give more oxygen to the cells. But what ATN does is it decreases this nitric oxide production. So the vasodilator production is impaired. This will further reduce the renal blood flow to the glomerulus and decrease the GFR more. Also, if you may recall from our ischemic reperfusion injury video, if we try to reperfuse a cell which has already been damaged, we can paradoxically cause it more harm by free radical formation, and this will increase the toxic effects to the cell, damaging it even more. To sum up, the initiation phase of acute tubular necrosis is a combination of all these effects. The ultimate result is the GFR being decreased. Number 2, maintenance phase. The maintenance phase of ATN is characterized by a stabilization of GFR at an extremely low level. Also, oliguria, which is the passing of less urine than normal. And uremia, a complication that happens when urea builds up in the body. This phase will typically last 1 to 3 weeks. Number 3. Recovery phase. Recovery phase is when the renal tubules recover. So this is characterized by regeneration of tubular epithelial cells. Apart from that, during recovery, an abnormal diuresis, which means you lose a lot of water from the body. So a person in the recovery phase of ATN will pass a lot of urine. Because you're passing a lot of urine, the accumulated urea nitrogen and the creatinine will also pass along with that urine and decrease the BUN and serum creatinine levels. Right, that's a brief summary of the 3 stages of ATN. I hope you guys understood and also learned something. Please comment down below if you do have any questions. I'll see you again with another video.